In the month of May 2014, Dr. Kalam, Sheridan and I, we had the opportunity to go to the University of Edinburgh. Edinburgh is the capital of the country called Scotland. Now, Scotland is a part of the United Kingdom, as you all know. Now, in the university, Dr. Kalam visited many research centers. One of the research centers was called the Anne Rowling Neurological Research Center. Anne Rowling is the mother of J.K. Rowling. I'm sure you know J.K. Rowling is the author of the famous Harry Potter. So this center was built in the memory of the author of Harry Potter and dedicated entirely to neuroscience research. And we visited many labs. There were several rooms and we went to see all those experiments, all those new healthcare technologies which were coming. And then Dr. Kalam, he came to one particular desk where there was a young girl who was doing an experiment on a very special thing. She was creating a voice bank. A voice bank is basically used by those people who are going through a slow brain degeneration and would eventually lose their voice. So what they were doing is that they were taking recordings of these people so that when they lose their voice, because their brain will stop functioning, that part of the brain, they will give this voice back to a computer, an artificial intelligence. And this artificial intelligence can keep talking in their voice. Dr. Kalam stopped at this research area for a long time. And she kept asking this girl several questions, this young doctor girl, researcher. And he asked her one question. You know, if right now you are recording people who can still speak and putting them in a voice bank, what if I give you a recording from the past, a huge amount of recording from the past of someone, and then can you create a voice bank by this historic data? And he kept querying and querying and spent about 10-15 minutes, which was very unlikely for him to spend at one particular person. Of course, the visit ended. We were slightly delayed because of this particular hang-up we had. And then when we sat in the car, we were sitting together. And I asked Dr. Kalam, why were we stopping at that one particular project? What was so interesting in it? You know, I have a friend. That friend of mine, he had a beautiful voice. He spoke very fluently. Absolutely impeccable speech. Everybody loved when he spoke. But that friend now finds very difficult to speak anything. And I only have recordings of this friend. And I wanted to give these recordings to this girl so she could put this recording in the artificial intelligence and I could hear my friend speak in his original voice again. And then I was confused. Who was this friend? I asked him. You don't know who was my friend? He asked. Oh, I will give you a hint. With his oration, he could shake up the nation. And with his poetry, he could bring people to tears. Can you guess who this great friend of his was? Then he gave me the answer. Was none other than my friend, Vajpayee. Dr. Kalam wanted, in 2014, to work on a project where he could artificially take all the previous speeches of Vajpayee, put it in an AI, and then try to give Vajpayee's voice again via a computer. And he wanted to gift it to him on his birthday, 25th December. Of course, both of these great heroes of the country are no longer with us. But the idea that the friend, the old friend, is always in your mind and you're always trying to help and do better for them is something which I learned from Dr. Kalam. Do keep following this channel. You'll hear more such stories and how giving and what can I give makes us happy. Thank you for watching this video. And do keep following this channel for more such insightful stories from the life of Dr. Kalam and several other heroes. Thank you.